There are two ways through life. The way of nature and the way of grace. Father, mother, always you rest inside me. Always you will.
Someday we'll fall down and weep. And we'll understand it all. All things.
Guide us to the end of time.
Unless you love, your life will flash by.
These are knife-edge moments when the mythic cuts through the temporal to reveal the timeless, where the spirit is elevated to its superior states, where the poetic takes flight over the rational. In moments such as these, the gods awaken and reclaim their seat in the soul. We can hear them when we call out for them. In the crash of thunder, in the solemn song of eternal dawn, and we wait for the furor of their return.
Look at your own face once again.
You see, none of it was real. It was illusion. Your art, your science, it was all a nightmare. Now it's done. Finished.
People should not be afraid of their governments. Governments should be afraid.
There is no going back. Our enemy pushes us on and on and on. And until we're strong enough, or can find Earth and get help, we can never stop or turn
people
away.
People should not be afraid of their governments.
It's got to shine from the high ground, standing in the mud.
I am not a number. I am a freedom.
Choice is an illusion created between those with power and those who have not.
When, like brave vampires, timid creatures of the forgotten night, we spread our arms against the rising suns of hating angels and soul-killing societies during the dawns of our illusionary Waterloos, permitting them to claim victory as our Eidolon, our false selves, melt, evaporate. We don't give a unicorn's patoot, because what is left from our ashes are our moments of universal compassion, our blazing memories of intimate tenderness, our artistic legacies forever stamped in the constellations of the collective unconscious. What is left, in essence, is our divine spark.
You and I, we have a higher calling.
Our tragedies are the actual winning of the war, our embracing without fear or doubt the abyss of a predatory universe is our redemption.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
We are the Gnostics, and never, never will give up, never falter in our wandering of the dimensions of consciousness, never flinch when the karma, Grand Inquisitor, strikes our cheeks and takes our cloaks. We are secret legend. We are the revenge of the myth. We are the true starseeds, planted to ornament endless fields of dark matter in order to wreathe a tapestry of divine beauty.
The light that burns twice as bright burns half as long.
We stand between the candle and the star, between the darkness and the light.
But we are all gods in the becoming, or should I say gods in the remembering. The Buddha didn't become enlightened. No, he just realized he had been enlightened the whole time. All learning is remembering, Plato said. And all ink had to do was see through the labyrinths of time and space to recall that he was both the Minotaur and Theseus all along. Full circle, completion, time to go to our Arcadia or Zion.
Dense, deep in the earth, sleeping, red and embodying the sun.
was so vast that the earth became their womb, Venus became their heart, and the Pleiades became their mind. The kings, they strove to create structure and form. They brought morals and justice to this world while it was dying. The queens embodied the stars. They brought down the wisdom that would become law, that would become embodied and made real by kings. Over time, as the density shifted, they scattered themselves into the sky. They became placeholders of a sacred circuitry, a body of stars, a pathway of ascension for the sun to trace for humanity. Scattered and gone from the memory of humanity, they watched, only seeing flashes, only seeing pieces, echoes. They were sleeping. Sophia was sleeping. Unable to speak their language, unable to take their true form. But slowly, the earth is coming back around. And the cosmos is again beginning to reconcile herself into a point. All the scattered parts are coming together. All of the memories, the rituals of another time, the missing pieces, the warmth, all of it now rising.
I believe if you look hard, there are more wonders in this universe than you could ever have dreamed of.
Yeah, right there. Right here.
Kinesthetic Voyager, whose home is the road.
And I also know how important it is in life, not necessarily to be strong, but to feel strong.
And the human race is filled with passion, poetry, beauty, romance, love. These are what we stay alive for.
Every time I step outside, I feel nature is shouting at me. Come on, come and get me. Come on, come on, capture my mystery.
Everywhere we look, complex magic of nature blazes before our eyes.
The stars, can you see how they roar their light?
Come, my friends. It's not too late to seek a newer world, for my purpose holds to sail beyond the sunset. To strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield.
This is life.
Life is round.
An endless circle until someone breaks it. Bang! The whole world gets wider.
And the sunset, how fucking wonderful it is to watch that big ball of fire.
Call each thing by its right name.
So beautiful.
By its right name.